in the following weeks. It was hard to tell how much the Empire's situation was shifting, but one thing was certain. Changes were happening. With the death of their ringleaders, the Imperial Liberation Front's campaign of terror was finally over. And in recognition of our actions in Ruhr and at Corellia Fortress, all of us in Class 7 were invited to Valflame Palace. There, we were granted the honor of an audience with His Majesty the Emperor, Eugen III, along with Empress Priscilla, the mother of Princess Alphen and Crown Prince Cedric. But no sooner had we been thanked than we came face to face with the leaders of the factions that divided the nation. The heads of the four great houses, who rule their vast provinces with absolute authority, and the Chancellor and his close ally, Governor Regnitz, who brought reforms to Heimdall and expanded the railways. Both sides were quick to offer us words of praise, but just as quickly turned to criticize each other's role in the crisis. Eventually, His Majesty was forced to step in and rebuke both sides, clearly disgusted by their behavior. As it stood, the terrorists' defeat made it difficult for their supposed supporters in the noble faction to act openly, while Crossbell's push for independence was causing enough of a stir over there to keep the reformists busy. With both sides tied up, it looked like the Empire was in for a long overdue respite from its perpetual conflict. We'd finally gotten all the details for our concert performance worked out, and Elliot announced that we'd be doing two songs, a duet between Machias and Eusis, and a solo by Emma. To no one's surprise, all three of them were quick to raise objections. But after Crow and Elliot explained their choices and how their master plan would win over the audience, the rest of the class was totally on board, leaving our new vocalists to resign themselves to the inevitable. Unfortunately, with the good times came some sad news as well. It turned out that Marquis Ragnar was furious at Angelica for her part in what we did at the mine, and as a result, she was forced to leave the academy. Contrary to the official statement, her withdrawal was to be permanent. Before she left, she asked me if I'd look after the orbital bike for her. At first, I didn't want to. It felt like I'd be accepting that she'd be gone. But after thinking it over, I finally agreed. With so much going on, we decided to take Prince Olivert up on his proposal of a brief vacation north in Ymir. It proved to be quite an eventful trip, and it really drove home just how much we'd come to mean to each other. I'd tell you all about it, but we'd be here for hours. Maybe another time. Anyway,
could I have your attention, please? It's another great day, perfect weather to start bringing all your great festival ideas to life. Some of you have been preparing since last month, and some even longer. I know you're all itching to get started. So without further ado, I hereby declare the first day of festival preparation begun. Time to start setting up! We have today and tomorrow, but try not to leave any work until tomorrow night unless you really have to. All right, everyone, let's do this and stay safe out there.
Thank you.
This looks like a good...
Thank you. our chance. We can do this.
Here we go. Sorry.
I'll show you how it's done. Be gone! Ha!
It's my turn.
All right. Together, we're unbeatable.
We should proceed onward.
This looks like a night.
We should proceed onward. You're in my way.
I can do this.
It's my turn. Whirlwind! To me! Now!
There! Very well. Now is our chance! Don't let it pass!
Yeah, okay!
My turn.
I can do this.
Right.
My turn.
Now.
Here.
Thanks for having my back, Eusis.
I won't let you down.
What even is this? bad. Catch!
Thank you. Wow, this is a big one!
Ooh. Mm.
Wow, this is a big one! Bad. Wow, this is a big one!